video. As you know, the show is live, and it is also being streamed. So we are going to begin by putting on a 9.5-minute video of all of the schools that have been around for the last 150 years. Before we begin, may I ask that you put your phones on silent and no recording of the performance today. And we will begin in about 3 minutes. Thank you so much.
Thank you.
We are about to begin the show. Just a reminder that all cell phones need to be on silent. Please enjoy the show.
We would like to begin our ceremony today by opening with our invited, honored guest, Matthew Musso, the Indigenous Way of Life teacher. He is a singer from Sons of the Drum from Roseau River. Sons of the Drum is a well-renowned drum group formed in 2014 utilizing Ojibwe-style songs. They have traveled far and wide to share their style. In honor of Indigenous voices and tradition, Matthew will open today with an honor song. Before we begin, to respectfully honor his presence and to ask that he share his gift of song and ceremony with us today, I'd like to welcome Odysseia Petrishin, teacher from Sisler High School, to offer tobacco on behalf of the Winnipeg School Division. Tobacco is known as the first medicine gifted to Indigenous nations. In the spirit of reciprocity and respect, it is customary to first offer tobacco when requesting Indigenous knowledge, advice, song, or ceremony. Please rise.
This song is a welcome song. It's used in ceremony, and it's going to be used today to start up the ceremony in a good way.
Way high, I'll go high.
Thank you to Matthew Musso for that opening song. Out of respect for the Indigenous people of Manitoba, we at Winnipeg School Division recognize the schools we attend reside on Treaty 1 land, known as First Nations territory, as well as the homeland of the Red River Métis. Par respect pour les peuples indigènes du Manitoba, nous à la division scolaire de Winnipeg reconnaissons que nous nous trouvons sur le territoire visé par le traité numéro 1 et que les terres sur lesquelles nous sommes rassemblés font partie du territoire traditionnel des peuples des Premières Nations et de la patrie des Métis de la Rivière-Rouge. The version of O Canada that you are about to hear is a multilingual version in English, French, Cree, Ojibwe, and Tagalog, performed by former students Faith Bage and Melody Richards. This video was created by the Tec-Voc broadcasting students and recorded by CBC. Please stand for the playing of O Canada. Good morning et bienvenue à notre cérémonie de clôture du 105e anniversaire de la division scolaire de Winnipeg. Je m'appelle Lien Huynh et je suis un finissant à Collège Churchill High School et je serai l'hôtesse ce matin. Good morning, everyone. My name is Lien Huynh and I'll be graduating from Collège Churchill High School this year. However, for this morning, I will be your host. Welcome to the Winnipeg School Division's 150th anniversary. This ceremony will be held in English, un peu de français, and will be interpreted in sign language. I would like to begin by welcoming the Winnipeg School Division's current and newly elected trustees, Pauline Clark, the Chief Superintendent and Chief Executive Officer, senior administration, special guests, staff, and students. My goodness, it's hard to believe a year has gone by since our opening ceremony, and that the division is ending its 150th year. It's very exciting to think I will be graduating on the calendar year of the 150th anniversary. This may be common knowledge for some, but did you know the division started in a one-room shack with 20 students taught by William Luxton in 1871? Fast forward 150 years, and we now have approximately 28,000 students and over 6,000 staff members. I would like to introduce the Trustee Betty Adele from Ward A, and Ms. Clark, the Chief Superintendent.
Good morning, everyone, all the honored guests, students, parents, and staff. My name is Betty Adele. I am a trustee for Ward 8. I want to acknowledge Trustee Jamie Dumont is here from Ward 1 to join us also. I am very pleased to be here today to bring greetings on behalf of the Board of Trustees to the 150th anniversary closing ceremony. It was an exciting year for our students and school communities as many celebrations were held across the division. I hope that everyone enjoyed browsing through the 150th celebration book, which highlighted each school, past, present, and programs in the Winnipeg School Division. It was wonderful to have all our schools participate in the Trees Project by planting the 150 trees during the school year. I also want to thank the students and staff who helped create the many videos that were uploaded on our Winnipeg School Division website, displaying how the students joined in on the celebration at their schools. And I really want to acknowledge that this was a lot of work. I just want to acknowledge all the hard work that all the students and staff put in. It was just wonderful, and it is truly appreciated, everything that was done. At this time, I would also like to thank all those involved, all the trustees, the administration staff, everyone. And as I said, it was very evident to anyone who was participating in this that there was a lot of hard work involved in this. So on behalf of the members of the board, please accept our sincere best wishes to all of you. Enjoy the rest of your day. Thank you. McGwetch.
Thank you, Trustee Adele. My name is Joyce Wong. I am one of the directors in the Winnipeg School Division. As Trustee Adele had mentioned, our committee completed a number of projects for a year of celebration, a year of learning, a year of history, and storytelling. 150 trees were planted on school grounds across the division. Each school and program submitted information towards a hardcover book highlighting the history of the Winnipeg School Division, which is now available for sale on the division website. Each school and program created a 90-inch banner which hung on lampposts along major Winnipeg streets from most of October to May. And high school students from Sisler's collaborated with each school to create a video highlighting the programs within the school to create a digital timeline of the Winnipeg School Division. It has been an exciting year of learning. Thank you.
I would now like to welcome two WSD 150th committee members, Vice Principal of King Edward School, Lindsay Young, and Career Education Coordinator of Tec-Voc High School, Tracy Derbyshire, to present the Winnipeg School Division Time Capsule.
Thank you. The WSD 150 Committee would like to thank all the schools for their participation in the many activities this past year. To commemorate the Winnipeg School Division's 150th anniversary, students have built a time capsule. Each school has sent one item to be shared with the students and staff to celebrate the 175th anniversary. The items in the time capsule are unique to each school. Letters written to future students, pens, yearbooks, t-shirts, keychains, and much more. In 2046, 24 years from now, future students can witness how wonderful the Winnipeg School Division was and will continue to be for future generations.
Thank you.
I would like to introduce from R.B. Russell High School, the Metal Shops Department teacher, Mike Johnston, and Building Construction Department teacher, Gavin Webster, and their students, Larry Roulette and Leo Blythe, to bring out the Winnipeg School Division time capsule. The capsule is made of a metal, and the base of the capsule is built from Manitoba oak. The students from these two departments have worked hard at building the time capsule with the guidance of their teachers.
At this time, I would like to ask Trustee Adele and Ms. Clark to add a copy of the 150th anniversary commemorative book to the time capsule prior to sealing.
At this time, we would like to take a picture.
What an experience that will be, opening up the time capsule in 24 years. I wonder who's going to be around to do it. My name is Sophia Costantini, and I am a program lead with the Winnipeg School Division. I support, organize, and plan all arts programming for the division. Over the past year, the arts were strongly affected by the pandemic restrictions. Many initiatives were canceled or postponed, leaving teachers and students disappointed. It wasn't until mid-year that we started to see a shift, with more opportunities being available to engage in, learn, and celebrate through the arts. We have captured many of the exciting opportunities, and we would like to share them with you right now. Immediately following the art celebration video, we will go straight into a live performance of Tec-Voc's elite dance team, Dance Tech Company. This year, DTC represents 18th crew to continue the legacy of this dance team that came before them.
Thank you.
please help me welcome DTC 18 on the stage performing Latch.
My heart up when the rest of me is down. You enchant me even when you're not around. If there are boundaries, I will try to knock them down. I'm latching on, babe. Now I know what I have found.
Thank you to DC 18 for that wonderful dance. There we go. I would like to give you a fun fact. Did you know that in 1871, the first school opened was called First School, and the first teacher, William Luxton, was paid $500 a year in salary, which, according to Google, is about $12,000 a year today. Also, the name of the first high school in the division was called the Collegiate Department, and Nellie McClung was a student there. In closing, I would like to invite Chief Superintendent Ms. Pauline Clark to say a few final words.
Well, good morning, and thank you all of you for coming. We've collected here today from many schools, students, staff, honored guests, and it's really important that you all joined us today. So thank you for making time in your day to do that. 150 years, is even unimaginable in some ways. But when we think forward, and we think 24 years from now, so if you're sitting here and you are 15, in 24 years, you're going to be old age, 39. And what will you be doing at 39? You might even have your own children who might be coming to, I hope, a school in the Winnipeg School Division. So you think about your parents and how, well, you know, sometimes they don't always do everything you want. In 24 years, it may be your turn with your children. It's hard to imagine some of those things, but That's what the future will hold. I'm so proud of the Winnipeg School Division. All of you, all of our schools, all of the incredible work you do. Just looking at the students today, the energy, the way they have practiced so hard. This didn't just come from one or two practices. This was dedication before school, after school. And you all do that. Your teachers, your staff, all of you are committed to be the best that we all can be in making sure that going forward, the Winnipeg School Division is even more successful than it's been in the last 150 years. And we've done some wonderful, wonderful things. One of the questions I have is, in 25 years' time, we've got all these videos and everything that we were thinking we should put in the time capsule so that in 25 years they could be played. But how will they play things in 25 years? Not the way we're doing it today. You think back, well, some of us that are old enough can think back to DVDs and things that have long since gone into history. So what will the technology even be like in 25 years? Will people even be able to see the videos that we've done? Lots of things to think about. You've already heard about all the incredible people who put this together and this whole year, and I won't say their names again, but thank you to all of them. We had partners in business. We had partners who donated lots of things for us, the trees and so on. And we had people who worked hard raising money to help us celebrate the way we could. When we began, we were still, as you saw in the video, masked, COVID, separated from each other. Now we're back in more normal circumstances, we hope, and we can just enjoy and move forward. So on behalf of everybody, my colleagues who are here from Senior Admin, Trustee Adele, Trustee Dumont, and the other honored guests, it's my pleasure to bring this ceremony to a close and hope that in 2046, maybe some of you will be opening the time capsule here, or if you did something in your own school as well. So I'm just going to say congratulations to the Winnipeg School Division, and thank you to all of you for coming today. Thank you.
Thank you, Ms. Clark, for those beautiful words. I just have one more fun fact for you before we officially close the ceremony. Did you know that Gordon Bell High School and Mulvey School traded locations to accommodate the growing student population? I thought that was pretty interesting. In closing, I would like to thank our sponsors, our special guests in attendance today, the students, staff, dignitaries, and community members, and to the staff and schools who helped in preparation for the event. Je voudrais remercier nos commanditaires, nos invités spéciaux présents aujourd'hui, les étudiants, le personnel, les dignitaires et les membres de la communauté, et au personnel et aux écoles qui ont contribué à la préparation de l'événement. Have a wonderful afternoon, and on your way out, please feel free to take a celebration cupcake prepared by the students at the Tec-Voc Baking and Pastry Arts Program. I know, it is very exciting. To bring closure to our ceremony today, we would like to once again introduce Matthew Masseau to share a closing song. Thank you for all of your presence today, and we look forward to another 150 years.
Abuju, this song is intended to send you off in a good way. It's a traveling song, and it's usually sung at the end of any ceremony or any kind of gathering that we have, so I'm honored to share that with you today. If we can all rise, thank you.
Bye.
Miigwech. Thank you.